Have you ever thought about generating your incident response plans for Microsoft Sentinel incidents using artificial intelligence? In this video, I'm going to show you how we can use ChatGPT in combination with the new Microsoft Sentinel tasks to automatically generate cybersecurity incident response plans. Let's run the intro. Okay, so welcome to a new AzureVlog. I hope you're all doing well. I'm doing fine. So this is a great topic. I really like playing around with ChatGPT and artificial intelligence in general, but combining it with Microsoft Sentinel, well, I love it. And in this video, that's exactly what we are going to do. Recently, Microsoft did an overhaul of the incident experience page in Microsoft Sentinel. We now have a new feature called tasks. This is great. We can now write instructions for the cybersecurity engineer to resolve the incident. But what if we could automatically generate those instructions using ChatGPT? That's great, right? For each incident, we then have the right instructions to resolve it. So let's grab a cup of coffee, prepare a demo environment, and I'm going to show you how you exactly can achieve that. Okay, that was a great cup of coffee. So before I'm going to show you how you can use ChatGPT to generate an incident response plan for your Microsoft Sentinel security incident, let's first talk about tasks, because Microsoft created that recently. It's preview. So let me quickly show you around what tasks are. Let's switch over to my desktop. So here we are. We are at the homepage of Microsoft Sentinel. And if I go to incidents, I already created a demo incident. If I click on view details, I get to the new incident experience. And there's a thing called over here called tasks. It's currently in preview. And if I click on it, I can add a task. And this is just an instruction for a incident response engineer. So I can, let's say, for example, execute a KQL query, and I can give it a description over here. Execute the following query. ABC. Let's imagine that is a KQL query. I can save that, and the incident response engineer can check this as it's completed. So we are now able to add tasks to our incident which contain instructions. And that's actually great, because that allows us to standardize the incident response process. Each time the same incident comes in, we can add the same multiple tasks to resolve it in the same way. That's cool, right? So let me now show you how you can use the automation in Microsoft Sentinel to automatically add such a task. If we go back to the desktop and we go to automation over here, I can create a new automation rule. I can give it a name, add task. The trigger is when the incident is created. Let's add a condition over here. Title equals demo tasks. So each time an incident comes in with the title demo tasks, I can execute the following actions below here. And here we have a new action called add task. I can give this a title, a beautiful task. I can give it a description. So the description over here. I can click on apply. And now my add task automation rule has been created. So when I go back to incidents, I click create new incident. I call it demo tasks. Some description for the description field. I click on create. This will automatically add a task to my incident. So if I go now to tasks, we have a beautiful task over here. That's great. So we can use automation rules to automatically propagate the tasks for our incident. But we can go a little bit further. We can also use logic apps to add tasks to an incident. And within logic apps, there is the possibility to interact with ChatGPT. So let me show you a logic app that is interacting with Sentinel for tasks and ChatGPT. So here we are back at my desktop. I've already opened a tab over here. I have built a logic app that interacts with Sentinel. When an incident is created, the logic app is triggered. And then it will ask some questions to ChatGPT. In this case, I'm giving the following instruction. You are a security engineer. Can you describe the steps that investigate to decide whether a cybersecurity incident is a true positive or a false positive? Please write these steps for an incident with the following title. I've mentioned the Sentinel title over here, the Sentinel description, the Sentinel severity, entities, the MITRE tactics, and of course the MITRE techniques. We are using Sentinel as a SIEM. If there are some KQL queries that can help with this, please write them out in code and give an explanation what the query is doing. Please use escape strings in the output as the text is being used in a JSON document, limit to 500 characters. So this is quite important. Microsoft has set a limit on the characters that we can use at a task. I think it's about 1,000 at this moment. So we need to tell ChatGPT to do not extend that length. I've asked it to limit to 500 characters, as I think the instructions should be clear and not too extensive. So the next thing I'm doing is iterate through the choices, the response of ChatGPT. And what I do with the response, I add a task to my incident with the text that ChatGPT responded. And I'm actually doing that a couple of times in this logic app. For each step in the cybersecurity incident process, I ask ChatGPT what I should do. So here I ask what I should do to contain an incident with the title, description, severity, etc. I create a task with its response. Next thing I ask ChatGPT what steps I need to take to mitigate the incident. And of course, I'm going to create a task with its response. And lastly, I'm going to ask ChatGPT what I need to do to recover. And of course, as you guessed it, I'm also creating a task over here. Beautiful, right? So with the help of Microsoft Sentinel automation, I can execute this logic app. Let me quickly show you that. And after that, we are going to see this logic app in action. I really like this. So here I am back at my Sentinel workspace. If I go to automation, I already had prepared a create response plan automation rule. And if I click on this, you can see that for each incident that is created within the Sentinel workspace, we run the ChatGPT Sentinel workbook, or playbook as it's called. And that's actually the logic app that you saw over here. It's currently disabled, so let's enable it. So if we now go to incidents and create a new incident, and I know the data is not complete as it's just an incident that we created text-based over here. We don't have entities right now. I can give it a title and familiar sign-in properties. I can give it a description, sign-in with properties we've not seen for the given user. Well, let's give it a name. Jeroen at somedomain.com. Let's say severity high, status is new, create. So the incident is created. Let's go to view full details. We are here at the new incident experience. And if I now go to tasks, we see that the first task has been created. When I refresh, the other tasks are also incoming. So if I open this, we have a pretty nice instruction over here. Of course, we need to be very careful over here. ChatGPT is an AI which is trained on data up until the year of 2021. So not everything that we can do now is in ChatGPT. It's also not a perfect tool, but it's really nice to see the suggestions that ChatGPT brings us. So it gives me some steps. It even comes with a KQL query to verify sign-ins of this user. I think this is pretty cool. If I refresh, we now have all the things. Here we have some strange character sets. But it gives me some steps to contain the incidents, disable the account to prevent unauthorized access, for monitoring on the account, notify the relevant stakeholders. These are actions that you would like to do to contain the incident. Let's also have a look at the mitigate incident, temporarily suspend the given user's account, which is great. Enable two-factor authentication. Well, I like that one. It gives us also some options to run a penetration test and perform vulnerability assessment. Cool. Recover. Oh, this is mainly the same as the mitigation of the incident. So that can be a bit better. So a thing that I still would like to show you, or what you already have seen, is the way how I ask questions to ChatGPT. But telling ChatGPT you are an incident responder or something like that, it responds different than just ask the question, give me the steps to contain an incident for Microsoft Sentinel. If we go back to the logic app, for example, you can see that over here, you are a security engineer, and that gives us better results than just asking, give me the steps to contain an incident with title, description, etc. So the way how you ask ChatGPT questions and you also telling it how it should be respond is very important for the quality of responses that it will serve back to you. So if you are still here, that means you like this content. Please subscribe to this channel. That allows me to grow the channel and create much more, much better and much interesting videos than I'm currently capable of. So please subscribe. In this video, you saw how we can leverage the Microsoft Sentinel tasks and use automation rules to pre-fill the tasks. And also you saw how we can use logic apps to pre-fill the tasks with responses of the amazing ChatGPT. A warning, don't use ChatGPT without validating the answers it gives. It is not a perfect tool, but it's a really good source of inspiration. I demonstrated that the tasks were created using ChatGPT. You saw that. It was all great. So I hope you like this content. Again, subscribe to this channel. Hit the notification bell so you know when I upload a new video. And of course, I hope to see you in the next one. Bye.